Magandang hapon po, nagsasagawa ngayon ng press conference ng Philippine National Police kaugnay sa engkwentro ng isang paksyon ng MNLF at mga tropa ng gobyerno sa Zamboanga City. 4 na raw ang patay at 13 ang sugatan sa bakbakan. Panoorin po natin ito.
So, of course, the presence of the police and armed forces is there to implement the law. The presence of the police is to provide police visibility as the normal function of the police. At the same time, the armed forces. But with regards to MNLF, I cannot speak in their behalf.
Because, sir, they are saying that they were supposed to hold a peace rally and that is why MNLF members masked up in Zamboanga City.
Same answer.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next, sir, is Mr. Jack Batallones of ABS-CBN.
Sir, good afternoon. Sir, tanong ko lang kung may demands na ba binigay yung group? May legit demands na ba sila na sinabi?
As of this moment, wala pa. Negative pa. Mm-hmm. Again, we will update you at 3 o'clock.
Okay. Sir, Lasa, are we considering na magtaas ng alert dito sa NCR? Hindi naman. Wala pa.
We are doing everything to resolve the conflict as soon as possible, and we hope that this will be resolved immediately.
Thank you. Next, sir, is Mr. Edwin Cevedal from DZMM. But he is currently, are you home? Okay.
Sir, good afternoon. Your briefing says na there are 200 persons stranded in Santa Catalina.
Yes.
When you say stranded, what does it mean? Kasi may sinasabing hostage taking sa Santa Catalina. Are they hostages or they cannot just leave the area?
They cannot just leave the area.
So hindi po sila, they're not under the custody of the MNLF?
No.
Mm-hmm. Kasi we got an information na umabot na nga raw 200 yung hostages. So may katotohanan po yun?
Wala pa.
So ilan po yung hostages na hawak ngayon?
As the latest report that we have is more or less 20.
So more or less 20.
Yes.
Sir, do you have an idea what building sila naka-confine itong mga hostages and the hostage takers?
We don't have that information yet as of now.
Mm-hmm. The AFP in their press briefing a while ago, they mentioned that 3 days ago they received an intel report that the MNLF will be proceeding to Zamboanga City. And then they confirmed last night na these MNLF are armed. So, nagkaya po nagkaroon ng deployment. On the side of the PNP, were you given such intel report?
I cannot answer in behalf of the regional director. Perhaps we can check with the regional director on that information.
Mm-hmm. Sir, what's the latest, sir, regarding the situation in Zamboanga City? Kasi I heard or I talked to someone a while ago, no? In Zamboanga City, na ang description niya is ghost town. Walang sasakyan, walang kuryente. So, hindi ko lang ma-confirm, sir, kung buong Zamboanga ba yan. So, what's the latest that you're getting from Zamboanga City?
As of now, we don't have that report yet. But again, the PNP is doing its best to get back to normalcy in the city, the life in the city.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Edwin. Ms. Tuesday New from DZBB.
Hi, sir. Sir, as of this time, meron na po ba tayong information sa whereabouts ni Chairman Nurmiswari at meron na po bang pakikipag-coordination sa kanya or communication sa kanya para po makontrol itong situation sa Zamboanga?
As of now, Tuesday, wala pa tayong information as regard to the whereabouts of Nurmiswari.
Opo. Follow-up lang, sir. Hindi po kaya kumalat po sa ilang lugar, kanugnog ng Zamboanga City, itong nangyayari ngayon doon? Ano po ang ginagawa nating mga measures para ma-prevent po yung ganito ring incidents?
As again, the Police Regional Office 9 under Chief Superintendent Banyu is doing their best to ensure that the conflict or the situation in Zamboanga City will be resolved as soon as possible.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Next is Mr. Dennis Carcamo from Philstar.com.
Hello. Good afternoon, sir. Sir, with the situation, pwede po bang ilagay natin sa state of emergency itong Zamboanga? May possibility po ba? pagka hindi siya na-resolve agad within the day?
There is a body that will decide on that. But on the part of the PNP, where we are on the law enforcement side, we'll do our best so as not to escalate the problem, the situation.
Thank you, Dennis. Ms. Leia Ilagan of UNTV.
Good afternoon po, sir.
Afternoon.
Sir, na kung nabanggit po, ano po ang motibo at marami pong armed men na member po ng MNLF, although itinatanggi po ng MNLF na member po nila?
As to the motive of their action, again, I cannot speak on their behalf. At the same time, we cannot speculate on the matter as of now. Investigation will be done after, maybe after the resolution of the conflict. But again, rest assured that the PNP is doing its best.
Sir, meron na po ba tayong name nung police po na nasawi ni isa?
May I request everyone to at first withhold the name of the person for the security of the family.
Thank you. We have a follow-up question, sir, from Mr. Aaron Requenco of Manila Bulletin.
Sir, yung sa meron ba, based on the reports from the field, meron na ba tayong number ng evacuees so far at kung may mga kung saan sila galing?
Wala pa tayo errands sa ngayon, yung mga sa evacuee. We will coordinate with the local government units as to that, considering that the Crisis Management Committee is in charge of that.
But sir, yung establishing contacts with yung MNLF commander naman leading the dun sa area, yung government are pursuing na magkaroon ng contact, meron na bang na-assign na parang negotiator?
Wala pa rin tayo errands ngayon.
Thank you, Aaron. Mr. Alvin Baltasar from TB4, DZRB, Radyo ng Bayan.
Sir, good afternoon po, Colonel Mayor. Sir, ang directive po ni GPNP, resolve the standoff as the soonest possible time. Pagkatapos nagtayo na rin tayo ng ano ng yung incident management.
Oh. Yes.
Sir, anong projection natin kung sakaling hindi natin ma-resolve ngayong araw na ito yung standoff? Ano yung worst case scenario, sir?
There is an existing crisis management committee headed by the chief of the local government unit, and from that they will decide. As of now, the situation is there, and as it said, we will cross the bridge when we get there. We hope that this situation will be resolved today.
Sir, follow-up lang. Sir, may nakita na ba tayong direct link talaga? Kasi yung sinasabi ng AFP, MNLF breakaway. Pero yung direktang kamay ni Nuri Miswari dito, meron kayo nakikita, sir?
So as far as we are concerned, we don't have that kind of information. As of now.
Thank you, Alvin. Mr. Edwin Cervidal, follow-up question.
Actually, natanong sir ni Mr. Alvin. Pero sir, yung info ko, sir, there are two MNLF commanders who are already identified. Can you name them if ever? If you're at liberty, sir?
For security reasons, wala pa.
Pero sir, do you confirm the info from the AFP that this is a breakaway group?
As of now, I cannot say something about it.
Thank you, sir.
Follow-up question from Tuesday, you.
Sir, sabi niyo kanina may proper body to decide kung ilalagay ang Zamboanga City sa state of emergency. Sino pong proper body ang tinutukoy niyo? And ano po yung mga factors para i-consider na isailalim sila sa state of emergency?
The Crisis Management Committee is headed by the local chief executive. As to the conditions in which to elevate the situation, I'm sorry, I cannot enumerate us one by one as the conditions.
Follow-up question from Cecil Suerte Felipe.
Yes, sir. How would you answer, sir, yung ano na may failure of intelligence considering the number of armed men na lumalakad na walang nakadetect bago sila nakapag-initiate ng attack?
We will check with the regional director, Chief Superintendent Vanyo, if there are any lapses that were committed by the ground troops. And from that, we'll move on.
Thank you, Cecil. Gigi Manicad of GMA 7.
Sir, magandang hapon po. Yung pong unang na-aresto na 32 nung gabi, naisailalim po ba sa tactical interrogation or pagtatanong po kung baka may kasama pa or ano pong gagawin po nila doon?
Correct pala yung number. There were only...
Yung dalawa po muna tapos
dalawa
may
muna, tapos
30.
May apat.
Hindi, ah, apat pa. Sorry, apat. Apat, apat, apat.
Yes, yes. We don't engage in tactical interrogation. As the right of every person, then we observe the rights of the accused. As always, we protect the rights as provided by law. To emphasize, we do not engage in any tactical interrogation in the field.
If there are no more questions, do you have anything to say, sir?
Sir, one last month, yung as early as siguro last month pa sir yata nag-declare na si Normie Suwari, tapos mayroong mga threat na on the part ng PNP, wala ba yung parang monitoring na dapat mag-prepare for this kind of incident? Wala bang signals o ano na mangyayari to on the part ng PNP based on intel?
So far as of now, Aaron, I cannot answer that question as to that particular matter.
Follow up again from Cecil.
Sir, i-follow up ko lang yung tanong ni Ms. Tuesday na although the PNP is not in the position to decide on the declaration of state of emergency, what would be the recommendation of the PNP on that matter?
As of now, it should be resolved on the level of the regional director or the city. Much better.
Okay. And ang info, pupunta si Secretary Rojas and Secretary Gasmin doon. Si Chief PNP po ba is set to pumunta din doon?
The Chief PNP is outside of the country.
Go ahead, Aaron.
Sir, you mentioned kanina yung 200 na stranded doon sa Barangay Santa Catalina. So anong measure natin doon? Meron bang attempt to get them out or yung paglabas nila would depend dun sa negotiation pa with the MNLF?
We will direct the regional director to solve the problem and to address the problem of these people so that it will not escalate.
Can we say at this moment na contained na yung wala nang spillover dun sa other areas na kalapit dun sa pinangyayarihan ng action?
As of now, Cecil, the situation is still evolving. So we cannot say as to that particular matter.
Sir, saan pong galing itong
Ang inyo pong napanood ay ang press briefing na kasulukuyang ginagawa ng PNP kaugnay sa bakbakan sa pagitan ng isang paksyon ng MNLF at mga tropa ng gobyerno sa Zamboanga City. Kaninang alas 11 ng umaga ay apat na raw ang patay sa bakbakan, kabilang ang isang pulis, isang sundalo at dalawang sibilyan. 13 naman ang sugatan habang 20 residente ang bihag ng MNLF. Aabot naman sa 200 residente ang stranded o hindi makaalis sa kanilang mga kabahayan na naiipit sa bakbakan sa Barangay Santa Catalina. Tumanggi naman ang PNP na kumpirmahin kung ang nakainkwentro ng AFP na paksyon ng MNLF ay isang breakaway group. Sa ngayon, hindi pa masabi ng PNP kung ano talaga ang estado ng sitwasyon at dinescribe nila itong evolving raw ang sitwasyon bagamat sinasabing ginagawa na ng mga otoridad ang lahat para ma-resolba ang krisis sa lalong madaling panahon.